cross, for their hardness of their heart. Even so they were sent forth to preach armed with the manifestations of signs and miracles. And you, O Lord, ascended to your Father, the source of life, and they preached the word everywhere, confirming it through miracles. Therefore, we who have been enlightened by them glorify your resurrection from the dead, O loving Lord. And he gave his son to the army, he fed him, though he may. He patiste, O toque patere, he nubense, via natu exusa confeno, O alisic malotiste, O adamana que epide, he gatarane negrote, he epaide ferote, O thanatos de thanatote, que inises o pifime, Dio anitum despome, ευλογητός Χριστός ο Θεός ημών, ο ούτως ευδοκίσας δόξα σοι. Now and always and forever and ever, Amen. You are greatly blessed, O Virgin Theotokos, for Hades has been taken captive by him who was born of you. Adam was from back, the first was the fallen. He was delivered, death was put to death, and we were given life on you. In praise we cry aloud, blessed are you, O Christ our God, who has shown your good pleasure. Glory to you.
Mercy rest upon us as we have. Thank you. Oh, Oh, άγνωσμα. Σοφία.
Προσεφεσίωση επιστολής πάνω το ανάγνωσμα.
Πρόσκομαι.
Αδελφοί, παρακαλώ εμάς, εγώ δέσμιος εν Κυρίω αξίως περιπατήσε, της κλήσεως εις εκλήθητε, με τα πάσης της ταπεινοφροσύνης και πραότητος, με τα μακροθυμίας, ανεχόμενοι αλλήλων εν αγάπη, σπουδάζονται στη ειρήνη την ενότητα του πνεύματος εν το συνδέσμο της ειρήνης. Εν σώμα και εν πνεύμα, καθώς εκλήθητε μία ελπίδη της κλήσεως ημών, εις Κύριος, μία πίστης εν βάπτισμα. Εις Θεός και Πατήρ πάντων, ο επί πάντων και δια πάντων και εν πάσιν ημίν. Εν είδε έφερστο ημών εδόθη η χάρις κατά το μέτρο της δωρεάς του Χριστού.
Δώσ' πίεσέντα.
Make your vows to the Lord our God and perform them. God is known in Judah, His name is great in Israel.
Quick,
the reading is from St. Paul's letter to the Ephesians. Brethren, I, a prisoner for the Lord, beg you to lead a life worthy of the calling to which you have been called, with all lowliness and meekness, and with patience, forbearing one another in love, eager to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, just as you were called to the one hope that belongs to your call, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of us all, who is above all, and through all, and in all. But grace was given to each of us according to the measure of Christ's gift.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Sophia, orthia, cusme tu aio avendilio, perene pace,
et totem matisu.
Do not kill. Do not steal.
Do not bear false witness. Honor your father and mother. And he said, all these I have observed from my youth. And when Jesus heard it, he said to him, one thing you still lack. Sell all that you have and distribute to the poor, and you will have treasures in heaven. And come, follow me. And when he heard this, he became sad, for he was very rich. Jesus, looking at him, said, how hard it is for those who have riches to enter the kingdom of God. For it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God. For those who heard it said, then who can be saved? But he said, what is impossible with men is possible with God.
Thank you. Τον Πάντων και Οράτων και εις έναν Κύριο Ιησού Χριστόν, τον Υιόν του Θεού του Μονογενή, Πατρός και Ενιφέντα από πάντων των αιώνων. Ως εκ φωτός, Θεόν αληθινόν, εκ Θεού αληθινού, γεννηθέντα ούπι η Ιταλιά, ο Μωούς Πατρίς για τα πάντα εγκέντρο. Τον δημάσου ανθρώπου, Μητέρα Σωτηρία, καταρχόντα εκ του ουρανών, και σαν το θέντα κρέμα της Αγίου και Μαρίας Παρθένου Παρθοδίσατα. Τα βοθέντα εκ περιμόνε του φωτιού του λάθου, και παρθόντα και τα θέντα, και ανεστάν εκ τρίτη μέρα δεν τις αφάσουν. Και ανορθόντα εκ του ουρανού, και καθεζόμενος δεξιών του πατρός, και πάλι ερχόμενο με τα δόξους, πλήνε ζώντας και μικρούς, ούτε της βασιλείας και της δέας. Και στο πνεύμα το Άγιο, το Κύριο, του Σοφιών, του Πατρός Χορευόμενο, το Σύμπατρι Κύριος προσκυνούμενο, και εσύ το ξεζόμα το λαδί σαν διάρκο αυτό. Εις μία να γίνει καθολική και από στον την Εκκλησία, ομολογούν αβάσιμα εσάς των αθλιών, προς το βοανάσεις και νεκρών, και τη ζωή του μέλου των Θεών προς τα μη.
Creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light from light, true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, from all things are made, who for us men for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered with Mary. And he rose on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is yet at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge of the living and the dead, his kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who giveth the Father, the Son, is worshipped and glorified, who spoke to the prophets. In one holy Catholic Apostolic Church, I confess all baptisms and forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and life days to come. Amen.
So then,
Thank you.
morning, children.
Good morning.
Well, we've been talking about the church and what we see, and last week we spoke about the iconostasis, where you see here the icons, and we explained some of that, but today I want to speak about still the icons and the altar area. And let me show you what else we have here that many of you do not see at all sometimes. Because these are the doors. And these are the doors that only the priest that goes through. Because it's the Holy of Holies. It's the Holy of Holies, and these are called the royal doors. And where the doors come from? This is the order and where the people are. And this comes actually from the Old Testament. It comes from the temple, the Jewish temple, that Christ was born Jewish. He was a Jew, and he went to temple, and he worshipped. He worshipped every Saturday, and he preached in the temples as well. And he was the one that, we come from that tradition of the temple. What was the temple? The temple was that they had the temple was built, David, the son of Solomon, built the temple, and they built it in the Holy of Holies. In other words, they had the people who would worship, and then in here there would be a curtain. There would be, not the doors that we have curtains also in our churches, and doors, but they had a curtain, and it was the Holy of Holies. And what was in the Holy Holy? They had an altar, and they would do a blood sacrifice, but only once a year. And there was a high priest that was designated to do the service of blood sacrifice. They would kill a lamb or whatever was brought to them. And they would, there was a blood sacrifice, and when the blood would go down, it would spill out, and whatever they did that. And that was the way they had their service. And then something happened, of course. What changed? Christ changed. He changed it all. It had occurred. The door was very, very high. The door was very high, and there was a curtain that would block it. Nobody again was allowed to go into the altar except the high priest once a year. And when Jesus was on the cross, it says that when he died, the curtain of the temple was cut in two. In other words, from top to bottom. It was divided. It was just cut. Jesus died, and when you read on Holy Friday, most especially, you will hear, and the curtain of the temple was cut in two. That meant the break of the way the Jewish worship is, and the way Christ is, the way we worship. Now, we have the altar, the same as the Hebrews had, but it's not a blood sacrifice. It's a bloodless sacrifice. Jesus already gave his blood for us to be saved. And he told us, again, that not to sacrifice animals, but to do worship and do it where his body and blood is already given to us, and that's how we receive Holy Communion. So what we see here today, those royal doors, are the same as what was what the curtain was. In a sense, it was the separation between the narthex and the altar. And also, what was in the Jewish temple near the altar? We have over here the reserved body and blood of Christ. If anybody's in the hospital sick or something, the priest will take it, and he goes to the hospital and he gives Holy Communion to that person. And it's there for a whole year. Actually, on Holy Thursday, we take part of the body and blood of Christ and put it in the tabernacle. There's a case over here where we put there. What did the Hebrews have? They had the Ark of the Covenant, the Holy Ark, that contained, they made it, but it also went to Israel, Egypt. He went to the holy mountain, Mount Sinai, and on top of the hill, Jesus gave him two tablets which contained the Ten Commandments. And they built an ark, a golden ark with angels on the ark, and they put it in the Holy of Holies. It had the Ten Commandments in the ark. It had what they called the rod of Aaron. Aaron was the first priest of the Jews. He was proclaimed to be the priest. His line, Levi, was the line of the priests. And he had a camp when he walked in a desert, and it was a dead priest. He put it in, and it sprouted. It sprouted, came alive, and sprouted. And there's another thing that they had in the Ark of the Covenant. Ten Commandments, the rod of Aaron, and they had what they call manna. Manna is when the Jews were released from Egypt and they were going to the Holy Land, and they were in the desert. How did they eat? Well, God provided, they had other ways of eating, but also when there was no food, manna from heaven. It was like a dew, and it came to the ground, and you would eat that, and they were satisfied and alive by that, what they call manna. So they collected manna. We don't know what it is now. We don't know what it is. But if we ever find it, it would be nice to see it, open the jar, see if it's still there, which I'm sure it is. But anyway, that's what it has, the food from heaven, called manna. And so we have the same thing, really. Why? Because at the door we have Gabriel, the archangel, blessing the Virgin Mary. And who is she? She contains God Himself. God came from heaven as a human being, and she is the ark of the Christ. She is the carrier of the Lord. So how they have it, and we are again expanding on that, because Christ came into the world, and there's a division between the Hebrews and the Christians, Orthodox mostly, that continue the line of the temple from the day of Solomon building the temple to today until the end of time. So this is again the altar of the Lord, where the sacrifice, bloodless sacrifice, is celebrated for us to be forever. Because we're wandering too. We're wandering through life, just like the Jewish people wandered through the desert to find the promised land. We are wandering through life to find the kingdom of heaven, where our Christ, our Lord, and our Savior and Creator is. And may He bless you all.
Yeah.
exalted above the heavens. Let your glory be above the heavens.
Pure as Father's Virgin, for nothing to give birth to God, in
souls of your servants. Elias, we must have the answer to the miracle, the answer to the answer to the Father's tribulation.
Give me a lay son,
Again, we pray for the souls of the servants and departed servants of God, Sotirios, Adonios, Maria, Ioannis, Evangelos, Kostas, Christou, Paniota, Dragona, Asimaki, Demosthenis, Dorothy, Spiros, Anna, Charlotte, and for the forgiveness of their sins, both voluntary and involuntary. Servants of God, Andrew, Jack, John, Alicia, John, Spiros, Florianus, Spiros, Dimitri, Christina, Alexia, Dimitri, and Suzanne, who celebrate this holy feast. Again, we pray for the protection of this holy church, this city, and every city and land from wrath, famine, pestilence, earthquake, flood, fire, storm, foreign invasion, civil strife, and accidental death, that our good and loving God may be merciful, gracious, and favorable to us by turning and keeping from us all wrath and sickness, and deliver us from all just rebuke, and have mercy on us. Hear us, O God, our Savior, the hope of all those who live everywhere on earth and those that are out to sea. Be gracious toward our sins, Master, and have mercy on us. Το πατρίδι και το γιο του Άγιο Πνεύματι νυμπιάγι και έσχουσε όλα τον αιώνο. The supplication of the honorable, glorious, and powerful John the Baptist. The holy, glorious, and praiseworthy for the apostles, our fathers among the saints, the great hierarchs and ecumenical chieftains, Basil the Great, Gregory Theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasio, Cyril, and John, the merciful patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas, Bishop of Myra in Lycia, Spiridon, Bishop of Cleveland, the one who worked for. The holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the Victorious, Demetrius the Neapolitan, Theodore of Tyre, and Theodore of Sacrilatus, Minas, the wonder worker, Philemon, the Lethelius, the high martyrs, our venerable and God-bearing fathers, the holy, righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, our saints, Stephenos and Alipos, whose memory is remembered today, and of all your saints, we accept our prayer.
Amen.
Grant us forgiveness of our transgressions.
Amen.
Protect us under the shelter of your wings.
Amen.
Drive away from us every enemy and adversary.
Amen.
Grant peace to our lives.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy on us in every world and save our souls in the good and loving God.
Thank you.
saints of God, you bless the five loaves in the wilderness, and from them 5,000 men were filled. Bless now these loaves, the wine and oil, and multiply them in this holy church, in this city, in the homes of those who celebrate today, and in your whole world. And sanctify your faithful servants who partake of it. For you are he who blesses and sanctifies both things, Christ our God, and you we give glory together with your eternal Father, your Holy Spirit, now and ever and to the age of ages. Thank you. deny a certain part of me according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, a light to lighten the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel. What is heaven? Who's, you know, what is there? Who's going? How's it going to happen? But anyway, this man that gave him his life for others. They were shooting at him. They were doing all these things, but he had problems believing in who God was, and the Roman Church condemned the book. They said the Catholics should not read the book. And so the mind thought that perked up my thought. That perked up my thought. Does that person go to heaven or not? Well, the gospel says, unless you believe in me, unless you're baptized in me, you don't go to heaven. And yet, when Jesus was on the cross and he died, he opened the gates of Hades. So the righteous might go into heaven. The Bible tells it. It says that Jesus died on the cross, the curtain of the temple was torn in two, and the righteous rose from Hades, and the doors of heaven were opened. Did they know Jesus? Were they baptized? No. No. They were not. So it brings a question in. How do we know Jesus? Do we know him by our hearts and our justice and our righteousness? That doesn't bring us into heaven. We cannot go into heaven. We cannot go into heaven by our own actions. We can't go to heaven by our own actions. As a matter of fact, the man goes up to Jesus and he says, good teacher. He says, good teacher. He says, what should I do to go into heaven? And he tells him, the Ten Commandments, the lower part of the Ten Commandments, no adultery, don't envy your neighbor, honor your father and your mother, and so on. And he tells him all of that. And then he said, Jesus tells him, he says, well, sell all that you have. Sell all that you have and come and follow me. And the man said that, and the man goes away sadly, because the Bible says he was too rich. He was too rich. And Jesus says, it is impossible for man to enter the kingdom of heaven. It's impossible for a rich man to enter the kingdom of heaven. And the apostle said to him, well, then who can enter into the kingdom of heaven? Well, Jesus says it's so impossible that you can't even get a camel into the head of a needle. Camel, by the way, was a big rope that the boats would have, and they call that a camel. And it was the same as a camel, but you couldn't get that into a needle. You couldn't get that into a nail. What does Jesus say? He's really saying that we cannot, by our own thought of our own goodness and all the good things that we do, that we can bring ourselves into the kingdom of heaven. God, look at me, how good I am. And Jesus says, nobody is good but God. And if we are good, it is to the glory of God. So all this boasting of self and things like that, we get so many people that boast about themselves. Many people do that. Maybe me included at times. But we do that. That's our weaknesses. Because all of it is to the glory of God. All the good that we do is to the glory of God. And what he says is what's impossible for men is possible with God. In other words, that rich man, he did all the good things. He obeyed all the commandments. He told God, he said, he told me, I do all the commandments. And he says, I do it all. And he said, but you're still lacking. And that's what he's telling us. We're still lacking. That doesn't mean we go in shame and walk away. No, but to be humble. To be humble. Shame and humbleness are two different things. It's not the same thing. But to be humble. And to be able to love each other, and to care for each other, and to be who we ought to be as Christians. To be those things, and by that, God is the judge. I'm not the judge. None of us are the judge. There are people, I do funerals, and there are people that I never saw before. As a matter of fact, I happened the other day. Never saw before. Am I to judge that person or anybody else? God forbid. God forbid. Only God knows the heart. Only God knows the heart. How do we love him? Only God knows how we love him. Do we ever hear his name? Go to some places in
Africa, wherever. Did they ever hear the name of Jesus? Are they all condemned to hell? Personally, the church doesn't say anything either, but personally, I think they're not condemned to hell. If they're righteous and good and honest people, and love each other, and love others, and do things for others. That's my opinion. That's my opinion, not the church is sick. But that's, and this man, again, that I say of the doctor, I did all of that. My thought was, because I've always thought about it, I read that book 60 years ago, 65 years ago maybe. And I read that book, and that always stayed in my mind. And reading this pericope here of God, only through God, what's impossible for man is possible for God himself. Which means, if we know God, yes, all the more to say, I love you, Lord. To do all the things that I do. I worship you, Lord. Yes, worship. Only God do we worship. Only God. And so many things interfere with that. Why? Why do things between us interfere with the worship of God? Why, in heaven's name? Why? Does anybody know? Only God is good. None of us are good. We don't agree with each other in so many other things. But God, in his goodness and his righteousness, knows our hearts, knows who we are. And he says, love, if you say you love me and you don't love this, you don't love man, you don't love me. If you don't love your fellow neighbor, you don't love me. We gotta love God and love our neighbor. And who is our neighbor? Just like the prodigal son. Good Samaritan, thank you. Just like the Good Samaritan. That's how we should behave towards our Lord and our Savior. And may he bless you all.
Thank you. Well, that's why we have separate car wash.